Hello, welcome to Mastering Fifth Grade Math. We're going to be subtracting fractions. Here we'll have unlike denominators. Now you handle it in the same way that we did when we were adding fractions together. Basically, it's up to you to transform one or both of those fractions such that you basically need to have a common denominator before you can subtract them, just like we did with addition of fractions. So let's see how we do that when we have an actual problem. If we have 5/6, and we're subtracting from it 1/3, the first thing we do is check, do we have a common denominator between these fractions? And we don't. We have a 6 up here and we have a 3 here. So just like for adding fractions, we need to change one or both of these fractions so that we get a common denominator. Now since I know that 3 times 2 is 6, I can get a common denominator of 6 here, which will match this one. The way I do it is I say 1/3, and what I'll do is I'm basically going to multiply the bottom by 2 and the top by 2. And what that's going to do, on the top, 1 times 2 is 2. On the bottom, we get 6. This one, we don't have to change at all. We still have 5/6. And now we can subtract them because we have a common denominator. And so what we do is we just keep the 6 on the bottom because that's what we do when we have a common denominator. In the top, we subtract 5 minus 2, which gives us 3. So that's the answer, 3/6. But also, we always check after we do anything with fractions, can we simplify it? And we see right away that we can divide the top by 3 and the bottom by 3. We can do that as long as we do it to top and bottom. 3 divided by 3 is 1. 6 divided by 3 is 2. So the answer to this problem is 1/2. That's fully simplified. Now also, it makes sense because 1/2 of a pizza is the same as 3 out of 6 pieces of a pizza. So that makes us feel good that we've done the simplification correctly. All right, let's go ahead and do another one. Let's say we have 1/2, and we're subtracting from it 3/8. Right? So we check the denominators. We have a 2 and we have an 8. So that's not going to really work. But we see right away that 2 times 4 is 8. So I can transform this fraction to have a common denominator by basically taking the fraction 1/2, and I'll multiply the bottom by 4 and the top by 4. The reason I'm multiplying by 4 is because then I'll have 4/8. Now I have an 8 to match this one. Here we have the 3/8 that I don't have to change at all. And basically now I have two fractions that I can subtract. It's the same exact process that we use for adding. You're not really having to learn anything new here. But here we can see that since we have a common denominator of 8, it just comes along for the ride. And then we take 4 minus 3 for the numerators, which gives us 1/8. Now we check and see if it's fully simplified, and it is. I can't really subtract or divide top and bottom or anything to make that simpler. So 1/8 is the final answer for that subtraction. All right. Now what if we have 7/12, and I'm subtracting from that 1/4, like this. So I have a 12 up here, and I have a 4 down there. Those are clearly not, you know, common denominator, but I know that 4 times 3 is 12, so I can just transform this fraction by taking the 1/4, and I can multiply the top and bottom by 3 because I'm trying to reach 12. All right, and so what I will have is on the top I will have 3, and on the bottom I will have 12. This fraction I don't have to change at all, 7/12. And I remind myself I'm subtracting, so I'm subtracting 7/12 minus 3/12. Since the denominators are the same, I just keep it along for the ride. And then the numerator, 7 minus 3 is 4. So the answer is 4/12, but I always have to check, is this fully simplified? And then I see right away that I can divide the top by 4 and the bottom also by 4. 4 divided by 4 is